8:30 p.m. Saturday 4:30 p.m. and Sunday 3:30 p.m.
My name is Rejoice Mumalo. I'm the co-founder of African Dream Movement. We've been nominated for Campaign of the Year. Please vote for us because our campaign is going to really unite Africa and advance economically all African entrepreneurs, all African people, and we hope that we make an impact. Vote for us.
Hi, my name is Ismail Hassan, nominee on Entrepreneur of the Year 2015. Please vote for me on www.ann7.com.
Here at The New Age and ANN7, we believe in keeping ahead. We believe in getting the story faster and better. We also believe in our future storytellers and making them faster and better. To join our Media Academy, send a 500-word letter of motivation, examples of published work, your CV, and a copy of a valid driver's license to academy@tnamedia.co.za by the 28th of August 2015.
South African of the Year Awards 2015. And the nominees for Campaign of the Year are African Dream, Africa Against Ebola, MTN, Crime Line, Kagiso Shanduka Trust, Kiona Nedbank, Mo Fire, DJ Smooth, Protea Fire, Cricket SA. To vote for Campaign of the Year, SMS CAMP and your nominee number to 43043 or email CAMP and your nominee number to sativoting@ann7.com. African of the Year Awards 2015, and the nominees for Conservationist of the Year are Craig Spencer, Wildlife Research and Conservation, Div De Villiers, Green Scorpions, Fundisile Nketeni, CEO SA National Parks, Karen Trendler, Founder Wildcare Africa, Mark Boucher, SAB Boucher Conservation, Sinegugu Zukulu, Endangered Wildlife Trust, Yolan Friedman, Endangered Trust. To vote for Conservationist of the Year, SMS CONV and your nominee number to 43043 or email CONV and your nominee number to sativoting@ann7.com.
Good evening and welcome to I Am South African, the show that celebrates, profiles and showcases extraordinary and inspiring South Africans. I'm your host, Maps Mapunyane, and tonight in studio we're speaking to the co-founders and CEOs of the Creative Council, also known as TCC. TCC is South Africa's largest advertising agency group by number of staff and turnover, and it is currently a 700 million rand company. But before we get into the gentlemen behind it, Gilo Ved and Run Noina, this is their story.
We started TCC because we were two people who had no job. We were unemployable and we were entrepreneurs by heart, and we had to do something. So after a lot of looking, we found an old promotions company. We realized that you couldn't make money in promotions, and we started TCC as a promotions company. And I wish I could say to you that I had a mapped out strategy, or that we had a mapped out strategy as to how to get from this in-store promotions company to South Africa's largest agency group. But we didn't. We worked it out as we went along. And we learned along the way the importance of vision and strategy.
Started TCC, our desire was just to survive. There was no vision. I wish there was, but I have to be honest. All we wanted to do is just have enough money to get to the office to decide what we really want to do with our lives. But things have obviously changed, and I think now the vision is to continue growing, and most importantly, to continue to create employment opportunities in this country and change the face of advertising and marketing. It's an amazing thing to be an innovator, to be an entrepreneur in this unbelievably exciting country on this continent at this time.
TCC is a sales and marketing group. We've built the biggest agency group in South Africa, and we've done this by focusing on marketing that is non-traditional. So whereas other people focused on traditional advertising, where they were shouting messages on TV ads and on radio ads, we went out there and we said, how do we connect with the people? And how do we connect with the people in such a way that we change the way they act or transact? And that's TCC. We change the way people act or transact through bringing real life experiences to people by brands. It's been fun, it's been tough. People see the successes that we've had, but what they fail to see is what took us to those successes and how hard we had to climb to get to those peaks. I wish I could say that it became easier over the years, but the truth is that I found it very hard and very stressful back then, and I'm finding it very hard and very stressful right now to manage the business, with only one thing that I'm doing different. I've changed my mindset, and I decided that I'm going to enjoy every day that I come to work, and that's it. I'm here for a ride, and I enjoy every day that I come to work.
We're a sales and marketing company made up of a whole group of companies that are focused on providing solutions to clients, all aimed at getting consumers to act or transact.
Gil and I were the fiercest competitors right from the time we were kids. At school, we were the fiercest competitors, whether it was on the sports field, in our grades, in class, or whether it was getting the girls. We were competitors. And so we started a business together. We were best friends and competitors, and we started a business together. And both of us wanted to run the business. We both thought we could do a better job running the business. So what did we do? We said, cool, we'll split the business in half, and we'll each run certain sections of the business, and we'll be co-CEOs. So we co-group CEOs, but in real life, Gil is my biggest competitor. And I think I'm his biggest competitor. And we manage the business competitively. So I'm worried about what he's going to do, so I've got to out-trump him, and he's worried about what I'm going to do, so he's got to out-trump me. And then what lands up happening is we land up out-trumping our competitors, and by the time we look back, the competitors are nowhere.
It's been a relationship like any type. It's got its ups and downs. We often joke we're like a married couple, and we've got a child together, and we do what's best for the child. My partner and I are very different individuals, and it's like a yin and a yang. And when one is down, the other one picks the other one up, and vice versa. And we've allocated responsibilities based on our talents and interests. And somehow it works well because it's a real partnership. And it's a partnership of trust, of loyalty, of integrity to each other. And most importantly, we are both focused on one single thing, our baby, who is now a teenager, who we wanted to grow into a young, healthy adult. Employment opportunities for those that the economy considers unemployable. I won't stand for that. I don't like that term, unemployable. Upskill people and create employment opportunities, and you give them dignity, you give them self-respect, you give them hope. And that is the hope for this country, is creating employment. Without question, that is the honor that I've had. The single greatest achievement is creating employment. The journey has been interesting. It's been full of ups and downs, but all in all, it's been an incredible journey. What could be better than starting a company from nothing and having the honor 15 years later to look back and realize that you've created employment opportunities for so many people, that you're changing the face of an industry, namely advertising, and that you're literally taking people who are considered unemployable by the economy and creating employment through upskilling them. What could be a greater honor than doing that every day of your life?
Keep on keeping on. Keep on living the culture of our business, the brilliance or nothing culture, and try and make a difference to as many lives of as many people as we possibly can. And that's our vision.
I feel completely honored and humbled to be nominated by ANN7. This is a dream come true, and just being part of the nominees is an amazing achievement. And you know, if we're lucky enough to win, all the better.
And of course, we have Ren and Gil in the studio. Guys, thank you so much for joining us on I Am South African.
I'm glad to see you.
Thanks for having us.
Guys, before we get into what we're here to talk about, congratulations, or should I say mazel tov, on your nomination. What does this mean to you guys?
It means a lot. So obviously, we're very humbled. Recognition is always great. You never go into business for recognition. You go to do amazing things and change the world and hopefully make some money. But recognition is great and it's important.
Recognition is great, and recognition especially as being South Africans. Mm. We're immigrants into this country. We've been here since the age of five, and it's a privilege to be called South Africans. Mm. It really is. So really a big accolade for us.
Well, let's speak about that. Since the age of five, let's start at the beginning. What were Ran and Gil all, what were you both like growing up?
So let me tell you a story. Gil and I were born in Israel, in a hospital, 11 days apart.
Oh, wow.
We didn't meet each other till the age of 15. But when we met, we realized that we were born at the same in the same hospital, and we came to South Africa in the same year for the same reason. Both our parents were engineers, and South Africa was looking for engineers, and our parents came here for 1 year. And so we've been here since the age of five. We came as immigrants, and we were assimilated into South African society. And very proud to be South African.
What were we like growing up? Well, I met him when he was 15 and he hasn't changed much. Hungry, ambitious, entrepreneurial. We started our first business when we were 18 in matric. We started selling makeup in like cosmetic stores and chemists and hairdressers, hair salons. And unfortunately, it was just at the time when we were supposed to be writing matric exams. So probably not the best idea, but it made us enough money to go on holiday in Cape Town that year.
So you've always been entrepreneurs at heart?
We've always been entrepreneurs. I've been an entrepreneur since the age of 3.5. At the age of 3.5, I learned to use a pair of scissors. I cut out pictures or photos from an old calendar, and I went door to door selling them. And since I met Gil, we've been in business ventures together. Gil mentioned the cosmetics business that we ran. We ran our matric dance after party because we had to do it to make some cash. And we had a whole lot of businesses before we started Creative Council. Some were successful, some were unsuccessful. We learned way more from the unsuccessful businesses, but here we are today.
I must say though, just for the record, I don't think that I personally thought about entrepreneurship until much later, after being an entrepreneur for a good few years. I never thought about entrepreneurship. I always wanted to be master of my destiny. I wanted to be the director of my life, and it just so happened that is called entrepreneurship. Mm.
Tell us about the Creative Council.
Well, it started off as an install promoters agency. So, you know, like in the old days, you'd walk into a Pick n Pay and be offered something on a toothpick to taste. That's how we started. Mm. And 14 years later, it's now the largest advertising group in the country. And we do a wide range of services, sales and marketing solutions, all aimed at one thing: getting consumers to change the way they act or transact.
Basically getting consumers to buy things.
Yes.
That's what we do.
And doing so effectively.
And doing so effectively.
Yeah, because it's not about winning awards or about doing fancy work. It's about doing the kind of work that yields returns to your clients. Mm. That's your responsibility. And that's always been our single-minded focus. And whereas other more traditional agencies, with all respect to them, were, I think, focused on the creative and the touchy-feely stuff, as much as that's important, it's got to have one aim in mind, one single-minded aim in mind, and that is to get a return on investment.
That's the one side of the business. That's the one side of Creative Council. It's getting people to buy things. But the back end of Creative Council is around giving people, empowering people and giving them work skills. So Creative Council employs up to 30,000 people every single year, people that are unemployable, so to speak. We train them. We give them work. We train them on sales techniques, on promotional techniques. And they take those skills beyond the work at Creative Council into the workplace. There are many, many, many examples of people that joined Creative Council as promoters and today are sitting in director roles in big multinationals in South Africa. So that's the other side of the business. And I think that's the side that we're much more proud of.
One of the things that people say doesn't tend to work in businesses, working with family or friends, and you guys are practically family, let's be honest. You have such a close relationship. How have you managed to deal with those moments where it's tested the friendship? And what were some of those moments where the friendship has been tested and one of you has possibly thought, I'm out of here?
Yeah, it's a partnership is like any relationship. It's that simple. So for anyone who's watching, who's been in a long-term relationship, things are never always rosy. But to Ron's point, he said, we've got a child together, a teenager, petulant, cheeky, pimply-faced, lots of promise kind of teenager.
And 14 is a tough age.
14 is a tough age. Tell us, we know all about it. And we want the best for the teenager. And more importantly, we want the best for the 1,100 people that work for us full time and the 20 to 30,000 people that get employment with us every year. And every time I want to punch his lights out or walk away or do something, I remember we've got a child together. We're going to make this work for good and for bad. But here's the deal. We may disagree, but it's always about something that's best for the business. And that's what keeps us in it through thick and also through thin.
We also, part of our culture as people and the culture of our company is to argue a lot, is to debate a lot.
Yes.
And it's a great, it's healthy, it's exactly that. In fact, the pillar of our culture in our business is called healthy, heated debate. And what that actually means, if you read between the lines, is that you must debate everything, you must question everything. Because the more you question something, the better the answer that you'll get at the end. Yeah. And one of the reasons why we succeeded was because we challenge the norm all the time. Challenge the norm. We spend hours arguing about something that may seem petty. But at the end of the argument, I've had my say, he's had his. We've both heard everything that the other person has to say, and we make a decision that's right for the business or the brand or the customer.
We always say logic must prevail, but it's actually quite funny if you come to the office, especially if there are new staff that come in, they'll see, we sit next to each other and they'll come in and they see us arguing and screaming and shouting and door slamming and stuff like that. And in fact, our offices are completely transparent. We don't have blinds. It's really an open kind of plan vibe. And anyway, so new staff go to their managers and they're like, is the business going to close down? The bosses are... Obviously, it must be the end. And for guys who've been there for long, they're like, it's just another day at the TCC. It's that simple.
And when you leave the office, is there some good blood?
Yeah.
It's all still there.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sure.
We've got a baby together.
And it's only between 9 and 5 that there's a bit of tension.
In fact, well, we don't work 9 to 5.
There's no such thing as 9 to 5. And there's no such thing as 5-day week.
Yeah. We're in studio with Ran Noyner and Gil Oved from the Creative Council. Phenomenal entrepreneurs. And when we come back from the break, we'll have a lot more from them. Don't go anywhere.
Hi, my name is Skalk Berger, and vote for me for the South African of the Year Award.
Welcome back to I Am South African. I'm sitting in the studio with the phenomenal entrepreneurs from the Creative Council, the co-CEOs Ran and Gil. Guys, let's talk family. You gentlemen come from different families and you have different lessons that have been imparted upon you. What was your lesson, Gil, that has stayed with you along this journey? And Ryan, what's been your journey?
I've got an incredible family. I've got a loving sister, two nephews, brother-in-law, and two very, very supportive parents. My dad was an engineer who worked for one company for 25 years and was loyal to the day that he retired. And so he wasn't really an entrepreneur, but he supported me tremendously in my entrepreneurship. And I've had a lot of failures in my life. I still continue to fail very well. I'm a really good failure. But when I failed, before we started the Creative Council, I was tempted to throw in the towel and get a job. And my parents said, no, not a chance. Follow your dreams. And even though we don't understand what it is that you do and why you have the audacity to do it, we'll back you all the way. Follow your dreams and be an entrepreneur. That's a lesson I learned.
So my father is also an engineer. He's the most happy-go-lucky guy that you've ever met. And when he saw myself and Gil entering the, or Gil and I entering the activation industry and promotions and starting our own business, he was so inspired that he decided that he also wanted to become an entrepreneur. And so he resigned from his job where he had been working for a long time, and he started his own business and he succeeded. So I think we're both blessed to come from very close families. We're a family of five boys. My parents have been very, very supportive in different roles. My mom's been the more pressured one to push me to do things. And my dad's been, don't worry, it'll all work out in the end. So it's nice to have that support base, and I think family is very, very important.
You have beautiful headquarters in Johannesburg, which is a paradise to be in. You have a 700 million rand company, great number of staff. You're always busy. How do you balance that?
So
to be honest, we're two conflicting personalities. I think I've got a little bit more balance than Gil. I managed to keep fit. I don't know when the last time you went to gym was, but.
I walk around the office. You saw in the video, you saw that lap that week.
But you know, it really is about what you make of it. So for me, I'm quite rigid about, I get to the office quite early. I'm usually at the office by 6:45 or 7:00. I'm out of the office by 7:00. I usually do some exercise, gym, sweat, something during the day. And then when I get home, I try and switch off because there is time for family and wife, et cetera, et cetera. And you know, if you set yourself those parameters, you can do it.
We follow a very important six-day week. It's a simple philosophy, because 5 days is one day too little, because everyone else is doing the 5 days. You've got to be doing what others don't. But if you do 7 days a week, you'll burn yourself out, and you don't have time to think. You don't have time to be creative. You don't have time to reflect. So we love the six-day-a-week routine, whichever that one day is. As long as you have one day off to shut down and reset and restart, that's how we find the balance.
Is that how Creative Council works, or just the two of you?
No. They must work 7 days, 2 hours.
Well, we've got a chance to speak to both Rand's brother as well as Gil's sister, and this is what they had to say about them.
Gil is... Well, I'm in the unique position that I know Gil from the day I was born, not only as my brother, my confidant, and my best friend, but also as Gil, the business owner and entrepreneur. How I would describe Gil is fiercely loyal to the people around him, ambitious, passionate in life as well as in business. And just all around an amazing, amazing person to have in my life.
Ron is a special guy. I would say, you know, he's always been my go-to guy. So when I was a kid growing up, when I needed new soccer boots and my mom said no and my dad said no, Ron was the guy that I would go to. So he's a really like compassionate, caring individual, and that's like a different side that people don't see. So like in the corporate world, people have called him before, I think it's a corporate gangster, or he's got all these terminologies because, you know, he's extremely professional and efficient, and I'd say like he's very motivated and focused at work. But there's a different side to him which people don't see. And as a family member, like, he's someone that I've always looked up to. And I'll give you like an example to show, like, in business he's fair and just. So for example, I'll give you an example. When I was a kid, I used to have these jumble sales regularly. And what I realized was, you know, I'd have the jumble sales and I'd run out of stock. So what I did was, the one time I went into all my brother's cupboards at home and I took their clothes out. So I took all of Run's suits and everything, and I lined them all up on the street, and I was selling his Hugo Boss and Armani suits for 50, 60 rand. All of a sudden, Run arrives at home and he sees people walking down the street with these suits, and he comes to me and he says, "What the hell have you done?" So he forced me to go and find each of the people that I sold the suits to and go negotiate to buy the suits back. So he's a fair guy, he's a just guy, but he's an unbelievable, compassionate person. I've seen him help many people through business and in their personal lives. He's a very special, unique kind of guy.
Gil getting this nomination, I think it's totally exciting. I'm so very proud of him. I think it makes total sense, starting from nothing and building the biggest ad agency in the country. It's from his love of people and his ambition and just his desire to create thousands of jobs, which he has done successfully.
We love both of you, I respect both of you, and I really look up to both of you. Keep up all the good stuff that you're doing and keep growing. I'm excited to see where you guys are going to be in 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. I think this is just the beginning of the journey for both of you. Very proud of you guys, well done.
Congratulations, Gil and Ran, on the nomination. I will be there supporting you, and just bring it home, baby.
Awesome. How does that make you guys feel overall, just watching that kind of insert?
Emotional.
Yeah, very much so.
Yeah. Touching.
Your sister Maya mentioned that you were born an entrepreneur, and you've always had that bone in you, and that she's very proud of you.
I'm proud of her too.
Yeah.
She's done a great job of her own life as well. Yeah.
Your brother says there's a lot of tough love.
Yeah, tough love, but lots of compassion as well.
It's true though, I've got to interject. He's got a lot of compassion. He's a very generous guy, and people don't often see it because he's a very tough guy in business, incredibly tough, but there's a real soft, gentle side to him that comes out every once in a while, especially on a social side, family, friends. Yeah.
Like I said, my family are everything. Mm. My friends are everything.
Jeez, guys. It's always so heartwarming to see how you affect your family and the people that look up to you in that way. What's it like growing up with five brothers?
It really is the most amazing thing in the world. We're five boys, we're thick as wolves, thick as thieves. We always do things together, we travel together, we have holidays together. We're a very close family, we're a loving family. Friday nights when we get together and the whole family's around, you find that, while my parents are there and serving dinner and praying, we're all huddling together, and it's just the five boys huddling together, which is, it's something very unique.
It's quite funny because when I met Run, his brothers were very young. In fact, the youngest was still a toddler. Mm. And I've got like this theory of evolution, because Run's a really talented, smart guy. But, just like evolution, each generation gets better. Every brother just gets, one is a doctor, then the next one's like a maths genius, then another one's like, was the youngest MBA globally, and it just gets better and better. So
where does Yaniv fall in?
Yaniv is he's the fourth of five, so there's one that's younger than Yaniv. He's in India, he's developing apps in India.
Guys, now shifting from family to mentorship, you guys are two guys that are at the top of the branding and marketing industry. How important is it to mentor young entrepreneurs?
I think it's both of our real passions in life is mentorship, and in particular mentorship in this country. So I think to be able to mentor is a great gift, but to be able to mentor in this country is an unbelievable gift. And the reason is we've got a generational gap because of the history of this country. And you've got these very young, hungry, previously disadvantaged entrepreneurs who can't go to their families and ask for mentorship because entrepreneurship really missed a gap in their families. And really my passion in life, and I think Gil's passion, is upliftment of these entrepreneurs and mentorship of these entrepreneurs. And we're both very involved in several different programs to uplift these entrepreneurs. I think actually Gil's just finished writing his first book in this.
I've co-authored a book on entrepreneurship, and all the proceeds are actually going to an entrepreneurial charity, and it's all about advice for entrepreneurs, and it's all about mentorship, because there's nothing more important in this country than entrepreneurship. I think it'll solve a lot of the problems that we rely on government to solve, and we shouldn't be. We should be relying on ourselves, should be relying on private enterprise, on entrepreneurs to create innovation, to create jobs, to grow the economy. And so I think that's a big solution, and the only way it can happen is with real mentorship.
And that was my next question, which you completely answered. But we also spoke to a former employee, Hlumelo, and this is what he had to say about working with you guys.
Hlumelo is fantastic.
Basically, through the journey of life, he's a role model, the person who actually took me from where I was, entry level, just out of school, put me in a position where today I'm a professional doing, making my own money. So I'm doing this because I'm grateful to him. He has an extreme work ethic, an unrelenting desire to succeed. And so it's one of the things I did admire about him, but that's the most difficult thing of working with him, is that he is extremely driven, and therefore when you work for him, he basically drives you to actually become more. I was saying to my mom the other day, we in the black community lack role models, in the sense that the people we know, our community, our outer circle, we don't have startup companies like this. People who are young, that start a company, and today it's a 700 million rand business. And so for me to be actually introduced into a circle like that in quite an early age in my life, he was basically able to take me to a position where, coming from where I come from and the rough background that I had, he sort of created the bridge that says, your dream is possible, your dream is valid. And that's probably one of the greatest things I actually took from him. Run, for me, you have been literally one of the giants upon which my personal career and my life is actually built. So essentially, whatever you become, whatever heights you reach, know that you've changed the lives of people in South Africa. Coming from 2009, where I was basically on the verge of depression and I was lost in the world, and basically a person like you was basically able to light up my life, to create a pathway where there was none, to give me a role model and say, you know what, your dreams are valid. So from a person like me, who started from nothing, to today sitting here and being able to say, you know, well done on your achievement, thank you, you've changed my life, thanks.
Wow, amazing. That's how we come to work. That's the reason why we do what we do.
It's probably the most fulfilling thing in the world, to be able to, in fact, it's a perfect formula, to be able to have a business that makes you money, makes other people money, and changes people's lives, and that's, just does positive work.
Yeah, and in fact, taking it a step further, when you start a business, it's about survival, and it's about making money to survive and to just keep going. And then you get to a certain point where, really, as much as money is important, because you're in business to make money officially, other things take precedent. And for example, job creation and changing lives. You never walk into the office going, today I make X amount of money and this is it. It's just not the thing that drives most entrepreneurs. And I've spoken to hundreds of entrepreneurs, I've read so much about global entrepreneurs, and they all say the same thing. You focus on the things that move you, that mean something to you and that give you purpose. And ultimately the money flows as a result of it, not the other way around.
Yes. Now, that is obviously a massive compliment to have gotten from a former employee who's made a great success of himself as well, and he's followed in both of your GQ footsteps, because I can see you're both very stylish men, and he is too. But
have you seen how amazing this
amazing
this
the pocket change. Watch?
Yeah, I mean, that actually even
show us the time. Fantastic.
But on a more serious note, Clamello is one person that's been through the ranks of Creative Council, and I'm very proud of him because I know his story well, because I really worked very closely with him. I met the guy when he came out of school and he was lost. Like so many other people in this country, he believed that he was unemployable because people told him that he was unemployable. And I saw the guy, and he had an amazing energy. And I saw the talent in this guy. And I said, you know, just come, work with me. He started promoting phones in parking lots of shopping malls. That was how that guy started. Today, he's a great success story. And there are many, many, many people like that.
Well, there's going to be a lot more to come from Gil and Run. And of course, they've been nominated in the Entrepreneur of the Year category, the both of them running the TCC. And if you want to vote for them, all you need to do is SMS ENTR2, ENTR in the number 2, to 43043. Or you can email ENTR2 to sativoting@ann7.com. That's SATYvoting@ann7.com. We've got more after the break.
Hi, my name is Skalk Berger, and vote for me for the South African of the Year Award.
Welcome back to I Am South African. Of course, in studio we have Giloved and Run Noyna from the Creative Council. We've heard from your families. We've heard from a couple of your employees as well, a mentee. And now we want to hear from your staff as to what it's like working for TCC.
Can we leave now?
Let's have a look.
I've been working here for 4 years. So I've known the boys for 4 years. Actually, very privileged to be part of the family for 4 years.
The boys are interesting. I mean, I think they represent everything entrepreneurs should be in this market. Kind of go-getters. They'll do anything to make sure that they can please their clients and make sure that they look after their staff and the people that really support them. And that's what makes them really special. So they can be tough sometimes. But I think you have to be in a market like ours. Definitely.
The experience has been amazing. Every day is different. You know, you don't have a script for the day. You don't have, everything is different, basically. So it's a new experience. And it's been amazing, amazing, amazing.
Don't think you'd find a better example of what a work ethic should be, particularly from an entrepreneurial perspective. The boys are in on the weekend if there's a job that we've got to get done. They still touch base with most of our clients. And they're very, very involved, which is something that's rare nowadays. They have an insatiable work ethic. I've caught flights with them all around the world at crazy hours. I've been in the boardroom with them at crazy hours, but they're always here, they're never absent, which is something that we appreciate.
The Creative Council, as you know, it's the creative environment. So we have the freedom of expression. We also have freedom of creativity. So it's quite a lovely space to be in because you're never limited.
Fantastic. Congratulations, guys, on being nominated. And I think it's very fitting. You know, they took this business from two guys in a flat in Hillbrow to the biggest group in the country. We're the biggest first-time employers in South Africa. They really believe in the development of people and the development of business. They're investors in many businesses, and they're really behind making South Africa a better place, which I think is fitting for this nomination.
The boys have grown so much, Run and Gil. They work like any other individual that works for a company. From what I've seen, what I've experienced, for an example, Run is the first person to be in the building, and most of the time he's the last person to leave the building. That's how dedicated they are. So we learn every day from them, and I must say we love them very much. They are family to us.
Gil and Run, just want to congratulate you on being nominated for South African Entrepreneur of the Year. Lots of respect for you guys. Wish you all the best. And bring it home.
If there's one thing that stood out for me, besides, of course, the heartwarming words, you guys have a great relationship with your staff. Although you are tough and strict and things need to get done, it's quite a beautiful thing to see that kind of relationship where they can refer to you as the boys and not Mr. Oved and Mr. Noyna or anything. How important is it to create that kind of atmosphere in the workplace?
We have a very egalitarian approach to the way we do things.
All on the same level.
Everyone's equal. Everyone's got different roles and responsibilities, but at the same time, we're all in it together. Mm. So, and we lead by example. We walk the walk. We don't just talk the talk. If you go into our office, you'll see there's no fancy desk and leather chair or anything. We're all in it together. Our doors open, and we love being part of it. We love being in the thick of it. And we love the fact that someone can call us the boys, because that's how we see ourselves. And if you've got that collaborative spirit in your organization, you're going to be able to empower others to feel like they own the business, which means that the pressure isn't only on you as the entrepreneur or the founder. It means that everyone shares in the responsibility and the pressure equally.
Yeah, even though we are the CEOs, it's really all our business. It's we're all a family. We're all a family in this business. Some really cool words from the staff that you showed, but it just shows we're all family. I mean, those guys, when I watched them, it was as touching for me as watching my family.
Also, we paid them a lot of money to say that. they said it to script. I was impressed.
No,
did you feel that they were genuine?
Especially Jared.
Yeah, it was authentic. Yeah.
No, but it's fantastic.
Because I told him I would hurt him if he said anything. No, I'm just kidding.
No, that's awesome, guys. Before the break, we were talking about mentorship, and you've clearly done a great job with your staff with regards to that. But you were saying that you're angry at the private industry and the businesses for not being able to come together and solve this problem. But you were, during the break, talking about how angry you are at people feeling entitled about that. Expand a bit on that.
So I love entrepreneurship in South Africa and in Africa, but I think in South Africa we have a problem that there's a sense of entitlement. And quite simply, I won't take on or mentor anybody that has a sense of entitlement, because we had to work really hard to make things happen. And I don't believe that anyone is entitled to anything. If you want something, go out there and make it happen. Stop waiting for government to do it. Stop waiting for anyone else to do it. Get up, get off your, and go and do it. And I think that's one of the biggest drawbacks that we've got in South Africa is this sense of entitlement, unfortunately. But like we said, we're working on it. We're not letting that stop us. We're heavily invested in mentorship programs, mentorship charities, and we're gonna make a difference.
You employ over 1,000 full-time employees and over 15,000 part-time employees.
Yes.
How does that make you guys feel? And also, I mean, how important is it to empower these individuals?
It makes us feel very nervous and very scared, because every move that we make affects 1,000 people's families, lives, 15,000 people's families and lives. You know, quite often when I make a decision in the boardroom, in the back of my head, all I can think about is the 1,000 people's families that are going to either reap the benefit of a decision or suffer if I made a bad decision. And it really, really is a lot of pressure, and it keeps you in check.
Is it something that you try and keep down, or do you want to keep expanding on employees, or you just keep as many as you need in employment?
So let me be clear. As an advertising agency, one of the common themes of this industry is that people retrench when you lose accounts, and then you hire frantically when you win accounts. In our 14-year history, we've never retrenched. And it's been tempting at times, but we've recognized that we'd rather accept lower margins and risk our profits and maybe even make losses, but rather retain employment and retain the stability and give people job security. And our philosophy is very simple. If you come work for us, for as long as you're doing a good job, you're guaranteed employment. If you do a bad job, we'll get rid of you. We have absolutely no qualm about doing that, because you're bringing everyone else down who's coming in to do a hard day's work. But if you do great work, you're guaranteed employment with us. And that's how we've managed to keep it for 14 years. So to answer your question, do we want to keep growing it? Absolutely. The more people I can afford to employ, the better. Bring it on. And not only in South Africa, in the rest of Africa. And that's our next plan.
What was that tipping point 14 years ago, just the two of you, no funding, working from an office or a room in Hillbrow, and then all just started rolling together?
So when we started the business on the 1st of August 2001, and I'd say until the following year, March or April, we were losing money, we hadn't drawn a salary, we were in a terrible office. And you know, when you haven't earned income for a year and you spend money on rent every month and you have to bum off people and really you have to operate to get out of situations where you need to pay bills. The turning point for us was Danone, the company Danone that makes yogurts. I walked in there. I had been cold calling them for months. I had a spreadsheet literally with tens of calls. And I had a lucky break. I phoned and somehow the lady who answered the phone knew me from school. And she said, oh, of course, I'll have a coffee with you. And we had a coffee. And she said to me, look, we're going out to pitch on the business next week. You're late, but I'll get you into the pitch. Great. So I took the pitch. And remember, we had no money. We had zero. We were hardly paying our rent. We were bumming money to pay rent.
In fact, you're probably in debt as well.
We're in debt. We haven't earned an income. We've lost all our confidence. Our parents don't want to support us anymore. Well, they never did support us. But our friends don't want to hear about us bumming money from them. And there's this tender document out that says, you can become Danone's preferred supplier, but you've got to have refrigeration facilities so you never break the cold chain with the yogurt. You've got to make sure you have refrigerated trucks. We couldn't even pay $5,000 rent. Anyway, so I got back to the office and I told Gil about this tender.
I don't mean to cut you, but at what age is all of this happening?
This is
25, 26.
25, 26. And I got back to the office. I said to Gil, look, we've got the tender document. And for the first time in my life, I opened PowerPoint. And I started putting together a presentation. And my presentation was a grand total of 6 slides. And the next week I went back to Revert and I was sitting outside the room where they were evaluating all the people. And the guys before me walked out. And there were 6 or 7 of them. And they walked out, you know, with a token old guy and the young guy and the creative and the portfolio. And I walked in there, I didn't even know how to use PowerPoint. And I plugged in the laptop. And I'll never forget that I looked at this boardroom table full of people, the general manager, the marketing director, the brand managers. And I knew that I was in too deep. And I closed the laptop and I said to them, I haven't got work because I don't have experience. I don't have experience because I don't have work. I've got passion. I know I could make this happen. Give me a chance. And they felt uncomfortable and you could see them whispering in each other's ears. And I wouldn't leave until they said to me, yes, you can have a chance. And I got my chance. And I ran the most perfect campaign. We ran the most perfect campaign at the time. And the next Monday morning, we got an email that says, congratulations, guys. Your passion went right through to the staff that worked in the stores. And we're going to take a chance on you guys. And the rest, as they say, is history, because that was our first break. Wow. And that was in April 2002.
That's an incredible story.
On the way to April 2002, there were many times when we wanted to stop, close down the business.
Guys, having unpacked what TCC does and all the amazing work that you guys do, it's clear that you guys are doing a lot of things right. But we spoke to a client of yours and we want to see if they share this view or not.
I have known Gil and Run since 2013. I've been working with them for the last 2 years. And it's been quite an amazing journey with them. They are the most exciting people to work with. They're very open to new possibilities. They're open to change. And we've gone through a journey with them from 2013 till now on crafting brands for life, creating brands of purpose, and creating brands that people really, really love. And it's been quite a learning for all of us. And it's been actually quite an honor to go through with them. They are very passionate, very driven, but also very humble people. You know, when you work with CEOs, sometimes it can be quite intimidating, but I must say I have not found my experience with them to be intimidating at all. They're very accessible, they're open to feedback, they're always keen to drive any change. And as their client, you know, they treat you with the utmost level of respect. So I've really enjoyed working with them and going through this journey where we've had many, many changes. And through that time, they've remained patient. They've shown a lot of resilience with everything that happens. The economy, you know, sometimes doesn't work out the way that we plan, and then we have some changes to the plan. And, you know, instead of them getting frustrated, they understand our frustrations as the client and our pressure points, and they've been very supportive throughout the process. Run, Gil, congratulations on its nomination. I hope you see that, you know, South Africa is watching. Your work is not going unnoticed. I wish you all the best, and I'm sure you're going to take it. Good luck.
It seems like your approach of brilliance or nothing is what makes you an industry favorite. Do you guys see yourselves as trailblazers?
Absolutely.
We
saw ourselves as trailblazers before we even started TCC. Yeah, I mean, you got to think that you're a pioneer. If you're going to be an entrepreneur, we always say, You got to be a passion-fueled optimist. You got to see...
You had to throw in that line, passion-fueled optimism.
You see, he gives me a hard time on TV. What is it? But yeah, we're optimists. We see life as being rosy. I think good entrepreneurs have to be optimists. If you're too much of a realist, you're going to get bogged down by all the things that you're about to face. Very often I speak to entrepreneurs, successful ones, and they say, if I had known what I know now, I would have never started my business, which is kind of true. But somehow what happens is, as an optimist, you find ways around it when you hit those obstacles. And that's why passion is so important, because clients will be responsive to your passion. They'll forgive you for your flaws if you show passion for them, for their careers, for the brands that they work on.
It also comes from loving the industry that we're in and loving what we do day to day. I mean, I couldn't imagine coming to work and not enjoying what I do every day. So the passion is actually fueled by the fact that we love what we do. Every day we get to work, and they mentioned I was the first guy in the office, and generally I am the first guy. But that's because I wake up and I can't wait to be in the office. Mm. And this is now 14 years into the business.
Mm. And also what we do changes all the time. So we always say that the day we can define our business, we're probably going to be out of business. We're always changing our game and innovating. So, yeah, I'm proud to say we are trailblazers in this very exciting industry that's constantly evolving.
What were some of those businesses that you did before you got into what you guys were doing 14 years ago? Because I'm sure a lot of them don't exist, or all of them don't exist anymore, because they didn't quite work out.
So Run has a very long, distinguished career as an employee before he became an entrepreneur. He did a whole 6 months.
4 months.
4 months of stockbroking.
I've only ever had a full-time job once for 4 months. Gil's never had a full-time job. So we've done many things. I mean, I imported shoes from Spain and Portugal and other countries. And I used to sell them from my house and then from an office in Hyde Park. I was the first guy to have a U-Ring, We Bring cell phone business in South Africa many, many years ago.
I had a TV production company with Vusi Zine. Or Vusi Twala. It was called Juwazi.
And you were a radio DJ at one stage?
No.
Did a radio show?
Something, piloting it. It didn't work out.
I always said you had a face for radio.
I'll just keep it like this from now on.
Well, clearly two heads are better than one, and Ran and Gil are proof of that. And we'll have more from them after the break. You're watching I Am South African.
Hi, my name is Skalk Burger, and vote for me for the South African of the Year Award.
Welcome back to I Am South African. We've been having some great moments during the break here. I'm in studio with Gil Oved and Ran Noyna from the Creative Council. We're going to find out from them now what they do for fun, as well as what their knowledge is on South Africa. But before we get into that, let's find out a bit more from their staff members as to what it's like working for Ran and Gil.
I think that has been one of the greatest learning experiences of my life. I really learned how to deal with people, how to manage clients and expectations. I've learned a lot about how to be resilient, and that hard work pays off. So I've really learned a lot from working.
They are one of a kind. I've learned a lot from them, and they are more than go-getters. So anything to them, it's possible. There's nothing impossible. So you just need to work along with them and get to understand what their ultimate goal is. So it's been an awesome experience working with them.
If I had to summarize it, I would say work hard, play hard, because that's simply what we do. We work really hard, but at the end of the day, we also play very hard with our clients and without.
Nothing is impossible. So you can do anything and everything and everywhere. Mm-hmm. So that's them. There's nothing that one cannot do and cannot achieve. So they bring the best out of you as an individual as well. So I've learned that from them.
I think there are no two other people in the world that I think deserve to win this award, simply because they are entrepreneurs. This business was their brainchild, and they've grown it from like a little embryo all the way to this great organization that it is today, on their own. So that's amazing.
It's an honor to them, and I think they deserve it. and I would like to see them getting nominated on more because of the kind of business that they do and their ethics behind it. So it is such a great privilege, and for me as the TCC employee to work for them, it's a lovely thing, and I hope they'll bring it home.
It's awesome. How does it feel knowing that no one hates the boss?
Or that they're all very, very highly paid for doing this. For doing this.
I'm just concerned that Varisha said that we play with our clients. what do you make of that?
Sure. Now, I must say, when I watch this, you know, like I on one hand, I kind of thought, gee, who are you going to interview next? I hope they're going to say nice things. But then I realized that they actually are all like family. Lesego, Varisha, Jared, Tabile, all of them. They're our family. They've been with us 7 years, 10 years. When Lesego started with us, she really started from the bottom. And today, she's really high up in the company.
And you didn't get her to sing. You should have gotten her to sing. She got the most unbelievable voice.
But you got to find that talent in people. She's fantastic. She really is a fantastic person. People follow her, listen to her.
What does it mean to you guys to be proudly South African?
It's the best country in the world. It's that simple. We've got a country filled with opportunities, a country filled with amazing people with incredible warmth. We travel the world a lot. And I love traveling. I love seeing the world. But what I love most is coming home. And as soon as you come home, you can feel it. Everyone is smiling. I'll give you an example. The guy sitting at passport control. Now, you go anywhere in the world, they're proper a-holes. They've got the sour face welcoming you. It's like you're depressed to walk into their country. You come to South Africa, eta, shap, 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 chik, chik, and you walk through. And that's how it all starts. And it just goes from there.
That's the moment you're just like, I'm home.
Yeah, it's a unique place. We travel the world. We've seen many different cultures in many different countries. But this place is special. This place is bursting with promise. It's bursting with an amazing, amazing energy. It's just the land of opportunity. And you've got to harness the opportunity.
Well, let's just see how well you guys know this place. We're going to play a quick fun quiz. So quick fire questions. I'm going to need quick fire answers. Who was the captain of the Springboks when South Africa won the Rugby World Cup?
François Pienaar.
There we go. Question number two. What is the national flower of South Africa?
Protea.
What is the capital of Northwest?
Polokwane.
No, that's not Northwest. Northwest is where the mining is, where they mine the plate. Not Rustenburg.
Close to Rustenburg.
Not Rustenburg. It's right next to Rustenburg. Wait, I'll tell you what this is.
It starts with an M.
No, wait.
Five. Four, three.
It's where the Buffalo King people live.
Yeah, close. Mahikeng.
Yes, there we go. Okay.
There we go.
Why didn't you know that?
Four of the five fastest animals live in Africa. The cheetah, the wildebeest, the lion, and the Thompson's gazelle. True or false?
False. No Thompson's gazelle.
True, apparently.
Oh, okay.
True or false? South Africa has deserts, mountains, escarpments, plateaus, grasslands, bush, wetlands, and subtropical forests.
True.
Correct. What is which South African political party is led by Chief Buthelezi?
Inkatha Freedom Party.
Got it. Question number nine. Name the first city in the Southern Hemisphere to install streetlights. Tricky one. It's a tricky one.
Kimberley.
Google. Google. I'm going to give you a bonus
That's
point for
partner.
That one.
That's my partner.
What unique blend of tea is grown in the cedar... Ach. Just too good.
Let the guy do his job. He doesn't even know. That's great.
Fantastic. Guys, and those are the questions. You got 9 out of 10. I give you a 9 out of 10.
Okay.
Very, very good.
But you know what?
What?
I'm upset about that one.
That's some advice to give to aspiring entrepreneurs.
Okay. So I'm hoping that after this year, we get to see even more promising, more exciting entrepreneurs. I believe in the people of this country. I believe in entrepreneurship for this country, and it's a simple matter of standing up, backing yourself, and doing it. Just do it.
And read Gil's book.
With that final word, read Gil's book. We are so thankful to have had you guys on the show. Thank you so much for coming on to I Am South African. And it really was inspiring and enlightening to hear about how you guys go about your work, and also the positive and heartwarming thoughts from all the people that you've employed, your family, as to the type of individuals that you are. And we hope that many will follow in your footsteps.
Thank you for having us.
The Creative Council's Gil Oved and Ran Noyna, the two CEOs, the co-CEOs, who managed to go from no funding at all to creating a business that is over half a billion rand annually. And that is incredible work that comes through entrepreneurship and hard work. And also they've managed to change so many lives from the people that they've employed and from the people that really just do look up to them and the amazing work that they're doing for South Africa, moving it forward and spreading into Africa very soon. TCC Africa is coming to you in a very, very short amount of time, Africa. Guys, if you want to vote for them, all you need to do is SMS ENTR2, ENTR in the number 2, to 43043, or email ENTR2 to satyvoting@ann7.com. That's ENTR2. Guys, do you want to say it?
Yeah. ENTR2 to 43043.
And there they are. Two minds are better than one. ENTR2 to 43043. Thank you so much for watching. I am South African once again, and we'll see you again. For myself, Mapswapinani, it's good night.